What's up, everybody? I'm Finn McKenty. This is my second channel, and this is your home for my Twitch highlights and my podcast. So if you like this and you want to see more of that and you want to join the live streams, there's a link to that in the description of this video. And with that out of the way, let's get into it. The next thing I want to talk about is the new song by Eskimo Callboy, Pump It. Many people have asked me about this. It has 2 million views in about 4 days, which for, you know, a relatively obscure metal band is fantastic. So these guys are clearly doing something right. Let's watch it and I will give you my thoughts. Okay, so already it's pretty zany, right? They're kind of doing an updated version of what Blessed by a Broken Heart was trying to do 10, 15 years ago, but just kind of never really was successful at. Eskimo Callboy, kind of borrowing a page from their playbook, but obviously getting a lot more success than Blessed by a Broken Heart ever did. You are the power of my life. Yes, this is like the scene version of Eric Pride's Call on Me. I want to pump. I can't. This band is German, so it's hard for me to understand. I want to pump it better. It reminds me of that old, like, SNL skit.
I'm Hans.
And I'm Franz.
And we want to pump you up.
This part's pretty good. I will say this, this is a very dated sound. It actually sounds like the stuff that they were doing like 10 years ago, which I'll talk about in a minute, but very dated sound going back to that like Abandon All Ships, like Attack Attack kind of sound from like 2011. But I will say they do it very, very well. Like any sound can work if you do it well. And I think that these guys do it as well as anybody ever did. Now that's just a cheat. That's cheating. Having butts in the video, let's put it this way. If you watch other metal videos, you're not going to find a lot of attractive girls in them. Let's just be real. So putting pretty girls in your video is already kind of a cheat code for views. It seems simple. You know, you'd think, I mean, in rap, obviously they figured it out. Even like the most thugged out video will have some pretty girls in it. Seems like it'd be obvious, but, you know, metal fans, they'd rather be genting in a colored room or headbanging in a grungy warehouse than having pretty girls in their video. Definitely getting some Blessed by a Broken Heart vibes here. I like how they've optimized this drum set for the video, like with these two toms super far apart from each other. I like that. People can't be so precious about this. You know, there's some drummers who would get so upset because like, but I play 4 rack toms. I can't only have 2 in the video. You gotta, you know, be flexible. Yes, this drum set looks stupid to anybody who knows about drums, but we're not making videos for other drummers. We're making videos for people that want to have fun. Her visor here, this reminds me of like Korean moms going for a power walk. A waitar, yes. Yes, the waitar, look at that. Did they have his waitar, which is like a, looks like a 35-pound plate or something, probably a fake one, made out of a guitar. I really hope that they made that specifically for this video. That's the kind of attention to detail that I appreciate. I'm not gonna look at the comments, but I bet there's a whole bunch of fucking powerlifting nerds critiquing their form and saying that they should have used a different fucking brand of dumbbell and, you know, you can't lift in those shoes, blah, blah, blah. I'll tell you what, people think that like bodybuilders and powerlifters and people like that are jocks. They're not. They're fucking nerds. Powerlifters are the biggest goddamn nerds on the planet. They're like as annoying as fucking guitarists. Like, what the fuck, man? Those aren't real plates. There's no way he'd be able to dance if those are real plates. Oh, you think? You think maybe they just use fake plates for the video? Gym rats are nerds who are obsessed with men's physiques. That's exactly right. You have to be the opposite of a Chad to take lifting weights that seriously in the first place. That is exactly right.
That's right. Z's will save all of them. R.I.P. Z's. Man, if Z's was around, I'd like to think that they would have gotten him in this video. That would have been the perfect video, is having Z's host a fitness, a group fitness class.
Pump it.
Exactly. Everyone on the planet is a nerd. Finn is the only human being that doesn't fit in that category. That's right. Everyone's a nerd but me. This is good. I actually don't think this is their best song. I liked We Got the Moves. I thought We Got the Moves was a little bit of a better song. Yeah, they kind of went full Oliver Tree in this one. That's true. This chorus is fucking good. Here's what's interesting to me is, like, I started hearing about this band. When did Hypa Hypa come out? Like a year ago or something like that? June of last year, yeah, 18 million views. People started asking me about this band when Hypa Hypa came out, and I was like, Eskimo Callboy? That band? Because I remembered them as being this band. I'm from the same local scene as them, and goddamn, they were hated back in the day. This part's pretty good, actually. This is the first song I remember from them. Way, way, way back in 2012. I remember when this came out. Muffin Purper Gurk. I have no idea what that means. But they've been doing this forever, since day one. This is horrible. From the chat, it says it pretty much feels like a completely different band. I don't think it does. I mean, it's still basically Goofy Attack Attack, right? Like Goofy German Attack Attack. That's not a criticism of them. I actually think if you told me in 2012 that this band was still around, I would have kind of hung my head in shame and been like, God, why? Why didn't they just quit and get some real jobs? This band is terrible. They're never going to go anywhere. But I was wrong and they were right. I mean, I don't know that they're the biggest band in the world or anything like that, but they are getting millions of views in a relatively short period of time, which, you know, for this genre is great. So I would say good for them. My personal opinion of this band is, you know, if you listen to parts like this, clearly they're a good band. Like, they're clearly talented guys. This is like a catchy song. Like, they can clearly play, they can sing. I wish that they would do something that wasn't quite so goofy. I just think comedy music is corny. Even if it's well done, I'm just never gonna listen to it. Again, what do I know? It's working for them. It could be one thing if they had been a serious band for years and then all of a sudden they decided to be this gimmick band and, you know, you could say, oh, they used to play real music, but they sold out and now they're just comedy metal. Well, they've always been that. So clearly this is what they actually want to do. And I think it's cool that they're having success. But to me personally, it's just like, it's just too corny for me. Let's say you're a metal fan, because I saw some people in the chat say, like, this is good music to get people who aren't into metal into metal. Well, I don't know. Is it? Like, if you play this for people, they're going to be like, oh, yeah, this is fire. I want more of this. I don't think they are. I think they're going to go, cool. Are you into Rick and Morty? You know, is that your thing? It's a little too nerdy for me. Would not be fun at a party. Nobody wants to hear this at a party. People want to hear Drake and Future at a party. They want to hear WAP at a party. They don't want to hear Eskimo Callboy at a party. If you like this, that's totally cool. I think it's well done. If they're happy doing it, that's what matters. This is only my personal opinion. I'm not hating on this band. I'm not suggesting that they change. Just to me, it's disappointing to see people who are clearly talented and creative just play basically comedy music. I feel the same way about Oliver Tree, by the way. It has nothing to do with metal. And you can see that he's become less goofy over time, probably for that reason. Probably because he doesn't want people to think that he's just like a joke. He doesn't want people to think that he's the new Weird Al. From the chat here, it says they do serious songs too. They just don't rate. And that's the problem. That's the problem with being a gimmick band, a novelty band, is the people who come to you for joke music, they just want more joke music. And that's not the worst thing in the world. I mean, they are getting, you know, millions and millions of views. So, you know, is that a bad thing? I don't think it is. If they're happy, that's what matters. And there's no reason to think that they are unhappy. But just for me personally, I would like to see them do something a little bit more serious, because clearly, like, they're good musicians. I would like to see them be a little bit less goofy, but they probably shouldn't listen to me, because, you know, the golden rule, if you want to be successful in metal, do the exact opposite of what I say. If I think something is corny and boring, then metal fans are going to love it. And if I think something is brilliant and innovative, metal fans are going to hate it. So my advice to Eskimo Cowboy is keep doing what you're doing. Don't listen to me, because if you do that, you will ruin your career. My feelings on comedy music in general, it's not for me, but it's working for them. So what the fuck do I know? Don't listen to me. Don't listen to me. If you're in a metal band, don't do what I say. Do the opposite. Play doomsday riffs, make grungy warehouse videos, do pop covers, play in goofy outfits. Do the exact opposite of what I say and you'll be successful. Yes, and be a nerd. Please get your tetanus shot before grunging about in your local abandoned warehouse. That's exactly right. Good advice.